The traditional narrative we've all been conditioned to follow: pursue an education, secure a job, buy a house, start a family, and then seek happiness, has changed. That narrative no longer holds true. The system is increasingly chaotic, and there seems to be no way out. Gen Z has been subjected to a lot of traumas. They seem to have lost their social skills due to the rise of the digital world, multiple governmental failures leading to severe financial turmoil, and the complete societal shutdown during the 2020 pandemic. This has left millions of people lost, lonely, and helpless, with no future to strive for. Isolation and loneliness are more prevalent than ever, and depression has almost become normalized. For you to even start to understand Gen Z, you have to understand their biggest influence, and that's none other than the rapid rise of technology and the internet.
I cannot stand how the news has been dogging Gen Z and calling them lazy.
I work 5 days out of the week, 40 hours a week, okay? I do not make enough to live on my own. I would not make enough to pay rent, water, electric, and eat.
But depression has almost become normalized.
Isolation is a death sentence for many of us.
You ever get lonely?
Yeah, I think everyone gets lonely.
Loneliness?
Yeah.
All the time. That's almost like a daily struggle.
Gen Z is comprised of those born between the years 1997 and 2012. Though often referred to as a time of crisis, from the Y2K bug, to multiple global financial downturns, to the predictions of the world's end according to the Mayan calendar, these years also brought some of the most impactful revelations. The smartphone, widespread home internet, and social media platforms like Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Instagram. Now you may ask, how is this relevant to anything bad for the mentioned generation? Gen Z was born in the tech boom. People now had unlimited access to global communication and information right from their pockets. At first glance, innovation seems harmless, but we need to understand that for an entire generation, they didn't see the changes as innovations, but rather as a norm. For those of us born between the 80s and the early 2000s, life divides neatly into two chapters: before and after the internet. Remember when phones were only for calls and computers were mere tools, not some portal into another dimension? Back then, our free time meant real experiences, not endless scrolling of cat videos. Fast forward to 2024, and our lives are dominated by screens. But growing up without this tech invasion has given us a unique perspective on modern challenges, even though we're sometimes caught in its addiction too. For most of Gen Z, they grew up doing everything on screens, from messaging friends and watching videos, to playing games, dating, documenting their lives, and even building their own identities. What started as a novelty quickly evolved into a dependence. People aren't just spending 15 minutes a day on their phones anymore, they're hooked on their devices. This has led to what I describe as a digital dark age. Gen Z is violently addicted to their phones, video games, and adult content. They resort to short-term pleasures to distract themselves from their challenging and depressing realities. Many individuals now spend over 10 hours a day glued to their screens. Even a brief bathroom break can turn into an hour-long scroll session fueled by short-term content, dopamine triggers, and addictive algorithms. The rise of social media has amplified collective narcissism and a pervasive desire for social status among young people, as everyone actively tries to make their life seem better online. Social media has completely destroyed the attention span of Gen Z, with people unable to focus on a video more than a second before swiping to the next reel. This has worsened to the point where Gen Z is unable to complete everyday tasks such as walking or eating without music or scrolling on social media feeds. And when there is nothing to do, their brain will start tingling and reach out for their phones for some dopamine hits. This is no exaggeration. In fact, it's heavily underplayed. This whole phenomenon is described as brain rot. It's so overstimulating that it might as well be rotting your brain. And I can't even imagine how much brain damage Gen Alpha would receive in the future. Considering my niece, who at just 8 months old, already knows how to interact with an iPad, it's definitely not a good sign. Since birth, they witness a world where people are constantly glued to screens. They might start to believe that staring at screens is just a natural part of being human. In today's hyper-connected world, we have the biggest loneliness epidemic ever seen. Gen Z has a loneliness problem. they are at the moment the loneliest generation in the world. This loneliness stems from anxiety about the future, constant overstimulation, and the pervasive influence of social media. Rather than confronting these challenges head-on, Gen Z often adopts a tough-it-out mentality to cope. People rarely go out like they used to, replaced by a digital landscape where most interactions occur online. From liking posts, replying to stories, sending cat videos, and making video calls. Because if they don't have a social media account to keep up with the latest celebrity news or memes, they are bound to be outcasted from people around them. As a result, millions of people have no one to talk to or find genuine connection with. Gen Z is resorting to living on TikTok and in the metaverse, or even finding anime or AI girlfriends. Undoubtedly, that was a lot to take in, and the future is not looking good at all. You have a generation that can't focus, resulting in poorer academic performance, manifested by many Americans unable to point out their own country on a map, thinking that Texas is actually a legit country. This, by extension, contributes to greater unemployment rates, with millions already hating the system and not wanting to work at all. This generation has faced systemic failures beyond their control. It wasn't their choice to be born in an era where algorithms and technology take over everyone's lives. And as a result, Gen Z will likely experience a significant rise in mental health challenges compared to many of the previous generations, starting at a younger age. Everything from depression to anxiety will be more prevalent than ever before. Looking ahead to Gen Alpha, we will definitely see depression in its truest and ultimate form. And with all the crap that is happening to the economical state of the world that was mentioned in one of my videos, it really breaks every spectrum of hope that Gen Z has. You see, Gen Zs are aware of everything that's unfolding before them, and yet there's little motivation or urgency to change. Why would you care about your addictions or bad habits if you're constantly told that the world's going to end tomorrow, that you'll never be able to start a family, or even buy a house? This is part of the reason that Gen Z doesn't want to work 50 years of their life and still not be able to afford to live. Things that have been the norm for generations have all ended with Gen Z. There is no debate. The system is broken. Education, housing, healthcare, retirement, all broken. Gen Z is at the forefront of a cultural revolution, witnessing the demise of every traditional norm. They don't just struggle with housing and living, but also have a very different dynamic when it comes to these two things. Both parents are often forced to work in order to live, which overall leads to less time the family has together. This, by extension, leads to breakups and divorce, making the single-parent household all too common. They've ignored creative and entrepreneurial advancements, and instead are just stuck living in the past, leading to kids being unprepared for the real world. With no one raising the generation, people are developing all their thoughts and morals on social media from TikTok influencers or figures like Andrew Tate. Now let's say you're a fluke in the system and you stop lying in bed, get up, and somehow land a job. You still won't be able to get a house. Rents are astronomically high, and mortgages used to take 3 to 4 years to save up for, but now it's 10 plus years to never. This leaves Gen Z, literal grown adults, 24 and 25 year olds, living with their parents as it's not feasible to move out. So what are you going to do with your life? When you understand all of this, there's no shock that Gen Z has a deep-rooted desire to hate the system that they've been told to follow, with many romanticizing the idea of living off the grid in a van or in a log cabin somewhere. Now, this may be satire, but it highlights the severity of the situation Gen Z has been placed in. The hatred for the system is further fueled by economic instability, as inflation erodes the value of money while income stays the same, with rising rates of crime, fraud, and depression. So I ask again, why change? Gen Z can't afford to live, nor can they afford to retire 50 years down the line. The world is falling to bits, with Western nations like the UK and the USA collapsing. And with the constant fear-mongering, multiple wars, and no hope for the future, can you really blame Gen Z for feeling this way? I would love to give the verdict that it's all going to be okay or that there's a simple fix. However, either all workarounds have been patched as of April 2024, or I don't find this to be the case. I was born in 1997. As a Gen Z myself, I wake up every day and work towards something that is strictly unobtainable in the current climate of the world. As I said earlier, Gen Z isn't blind to the chaos unfolding around them. They're aware of the economy, the unaffordable housing, and the bleak prospects for the future. Amidst the rubble of broken dreams and shattered norms, yes, there are millions glued to technology and addictions in a realm of blissful ignorance. But there's also a flicker of defiance, a refusal to accept the status quo. People do want change, and in ways the world has never seen before. Gen Z can create that change. But this won't be easy. Gen Z isn't just battling political issues or the relentless scroll of social media, but also far more extreme factors, like the rise of artificial intelligence and automation that can soon take the jobs of millions. But don't worry, it's not just Gen Z that has to fix these issues, it's everyone. Because if there's one thing that stood prominent over the last decade, it's that there are many odds that need to be defied. The future of Gen Z is no exception. This is the revolution of a generation, and it's only just begun. Thank you for watching. If you want to show your support, be sure to subscribe and engage with this video, as this is still, in my opinion, a relatively new YouTube channel. And of course, have a great day.